I just think this is so funny. I don't think I ever thought I'd be in a platinum lounge. High five. Keep waking up in the night. My ears turn red. I heard some shit that I said. You're probably trying to be nice. Found something and I think you all might like it. What is that?
Good morning. So, what is this about? I don't really know what this vlog, video blog, film blog. Don't really know what it's about, but I thought it'd be an interesting experience to do one once a month. This is November.
November.
I don't really know what to say to a camera staring me in the eye. Hello. This is my cat. Nigel. You said, need to cap, what am I doing? Let's put that down. No, I want to keep it. I had to put my sock on the bottom of this chair for when I spun around before, and now I'm sockless. But that's okay. It's an alright way to be. It's sort of like winter here, so it's sort of short hour days and cold, and it's a bit annoying since I've come from Australia, which is in summer. Fuck you and your 30 degree day the other day. Point is, healthy. I've arrived here in this place across the sea, pond, river, big river. It's quite nice, actually. So, where do I begin? I guess I flew in here on the off chance of meeting the lavish little pickle who we both ended up in the Platinum Lounge, which I've never ever been into before. And they've got these showers. They've got these showers, which are like as big, well, as my room here, which is quite large as you can possibly think. Oh, we sat there and we had a coffee and a G&T at the same time. Why not? Just a great little conversation. So I flew into Amsterdam, and then I stayed at this lavish little hostel called Eco Mama. Look it up. Am I advertising for them now? Maybe I should get paid for that. Anyway, first of all, the amount that I've felt welcome over here has gone like above and beyond what I thought would happen. I don't know what I thought would happen, but I didn't think it would be this like open, and the conversations I've had with people have just been like crazy dank. So I'm in a place called Reichweich. which is like in between Delft and The Hague. Obviously, Delft's where I'm studying at the university there, which is like a crazy place. It's like another little sort of canal city, kind of like Amsterdam. It's just all this amazing architecture there. I think because it was, possibly it was during the war, it was quite heavily hit, so they had to rebuild a lot of it. And so as a result, it's just like architects have just gone bonanza and bloody build everything you could possibly think of, which is, and it's all really out there, and it's really, oh man, you should see the library at Delft is insane. So yeah, I went there and I met my supervisor, who had a really good conversation with her, and she showed me around the lab, which essentially consists of like every single kind of manufacturing machine you can think of. She was just like walking past, she was like, oh yeah, that's where we're working on the driverless cars and all this stuff. Just casually just worked that into conversation. So met up with her, and then I came and found this house, little house. Yeah, with these two roommates who have just been like so open to welcome me into their home, essentially. Like some bloody random from another country who you don't know if you trust them, but like they gave me like keys on the first day, and like that's like a really good testament to the kind of nature of people here, that they're just generally quite kind of honest and trusting, which is really, really nice. I mean, I've only been here like what, 5 days, so. But so far, it's been nice. Current plan is to go down to Hossiger and find this surfboard shaper guy, Christian Bradley, who is a friend, this is the connection, hashtag Tasmania, a friend of the son of my old art teacher from college. And so he said, yeah, go over there, say hi from me, and good luck. So I don't know where exactly he is, but I'll find him. Be a quest. Oh, I'd be like Monty Python, maybe I should get some of those coconuts so I can make a nice horsey sound while I'm walking. Yes. And then going over to see some family friends in Edinburgh for Christmas, which will be La Havisha. And then after that, I think scooting over to Berlin for some mind-tingling, violet, vocal, bit of honey mustard beets? Beetroot? Beets? Apparently the music scene over there is like fucking amazing. Already since being here in Amsterdam, I've been to like these two really cool venues. One of them was an old school. During the day, they have classes, and then during the night, it like they shut it all down and it turns into like a massive club. So like it was a really nostalgic feeling where like you're in the bathroom, and you know how they got like that's the central like trough area where everyone washes their hands, and the cubicles are on the other side, and you can just like imagine being in like, you know, year 7 or something, and you know you're washing your hands, and it's co-ed, you're washing your hands, and you're sort of like looking to your left at like, you know, your year 7 crush over there, and you kind of like give, you know, you don't look too much though, because that's a bit too forward, but you want to show them that you're interested, you know. Or maybe I'm just crazy. It must be where they store stuff, because it's like a basement area, and that was where they had like this like kind of dance floor set up with these lights that would sort of like program to the music to go off in different parts of the music, and it was this massive space, so like it was kind of like a, I don't know, it had like a rhythm to it, and it would sort of go around like in a circle. Anyway, I'm not explaining this very well, but it was a very good time, yeah. Oh, I met this lavish dude who was working there, who was just like supposed to be working, and then he just stopped and was like, hey, how's it going? And he had like a great chat to him. He showed me some music to look up. One's called, yeah, which I can put in the link, because I'm a video logger now. Vlogger. Essentially, it'll just be the meanderings of me over the space of a month, sort of collated into a little filmy film. So, hope you enjoy, or not. Cheers, and have a ton of fun.